people.
So, who gave you that Kindle?
My parents.
Ooh! Is it your favorite present ever?
Yep.
Your mom and dad must really love you a lot.
They do.
Do you know what the best present I received was?
Nope.
A few years ago, Mr. Canman was going through the trash and he brought me home the most amazing picture for my wall, and it just looks so perfect. I can't believe how great it is.
Wow.
I wonder what some of the best gifts our church friends have ever received.
My best gift that I've ever received would be a friend, which is a gift from God.
My favorite gift I've ever received was probably my Rubik's Cubes.
The best gift I've ever received is my phone.
Okay. The best gift I've ever received is my cat.
The best gift I ever received was the birth of my two beautiful children.
My favorite gift is my dog Midnight.
The greatest gift I ever received was the Holy Ghost.
What is your favorite Christmas gift you ever gotten?
My favorite Christmas gift was a dishwasher.
My favorite Christmas gift I ever gotten was a Hot Wheels.
My best gift that I've gotten is my laptop.
One of the best gifts that I got at Christmas was an electric drum set by my parents.
The best gift that I remember getting as a child was my strawberry shortcake house and with all the little people that went with it.
I think the best gift I ever received was a gift my husband gave me. He refinished my grandmother's rocking chair and reupholstered it and everything.
All right, the best gift I ever received, I really wanted this big old radio jukebox thing that was a thing back then that everyone had to have, and Christmas morning came, I didn't receive it, but my dad was very clever and he had this big, huge present waiting, and it was my big jukebox radio that I wanted.
Favorite thing for Christmas is Dad always put an envelope on the Christmas tree with money in it. You never knew how much, but it was always something special from him.
I've got my room redone.
Those are some amazing gifts. Sister Snyder, Sister Tapman told me she had a strawberry shortcake doll too. Talking about all these gifts gets me thinking, Jada. I was wondering what the best gift the Lord has ever received. What do you think?
Probably the Holy Ghost.
Well, I'm sure the Lord loves giving us the Holy Ghost. I was thinking living a life that pleases God is a great gift to give God. Or maybe praise and worship is a gift we can give God every day. I mean, even our Sunday services are called worship service. What do you think? Do you think God would like praise and worship as a gift?
Mm-hmm.
So, Jada, how should we praise and worship the Lord?
By lifting our hands and speaking out loud.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, we should lift our hands and speak out loud to the Lord. Sometimes we think that worshiping is just singing songs to God, but we can honor God in so many different ways. We can honor Him with our time and with our ministry. We can give Him our tithes and offerings, but it's so many things. Worship is so much. It's honoring God with great love and obedience, putting God at the top of our list. Our main focus over everyone and anything because He is worthy. What do you think, Jay? Do you think that's the best thing we can do? So, what are some ways you've seen people worship?
By singing and by
those are good ways. Do you know that Grant Holloway and Hannah Culliber and Sister Steerhoff, Brother Cornell, and all of our drummers give their talent of playing music to the Lord, and that's a way to worship Him. They took the talent God gave them, and they use it to glorify God, and it helps other people to worship Him too. Do you think you'll ever be a musician?
Probably.
What instrument would you play?
Play saxophone or a violin.
Ooh, those are good ones. Do you know that praise singers give their talent to the Lord too and help people worship? They help people. They give people the chance to clap their hands, and then they help us to be able to dance unto the Lord by using their talent of singing for the Lord. Jada, do you know why we worship the Lord?
To make Him feel happy.
Oh, it does make God feel happy when we worship Him. 1 Chronicles 16, 23 and 20 through 25 says, "Sing then to the Lord, all the earth. Show forth from day to day His salvation. Declare His glory among the heathen, His marvelous works among the nations. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised." That scripture means we worship God because He's God. It's that simple. We love Him because He first loved us. We could just worship God because of all the stuff He's done for us. Has He done good stuff for you?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of good stuff has God done for you, Jada?
Help me when I'm sick.
He does do that. And all of those things are a good reason to worship, but that's not the only reason. We worship God because He's the one true God. He's the creator of the universe and deserves all the honor and praise. Jada, what if we're having a bad day? Do we still have to worship the Lord then?
Mm-hmm.
What types of things like having a bad day might make it harder to worship and praise God?
You might feel grumpy and not want to pray.
What makes you grumpy?
It's kind of hard for me to get grumpy.
Are you always happy?
Pretty much.
What about if Martha came and pulled your hair? Would that make you grumpy? It would make me grumpy. Do you know we're supposed to praise God in all circumstances, even if they're not ideal? Praising God can be difficult when life's not going well. 2020 has been a really hard year on a lot of people, but even though life wasn't perfect, we had all kinds of testimonies given to God this year in our testimony service. A real-life example is both Hannah Culliber and Vashti Tatman. Both had really serious surgeries this year, and both of them got back to church as quickly as they could, and both continued to give their talents to the Lord this year, and they both thanked God for being with them in that difficult time. They were great examples to all of us on how to praise and worship in a difficult situation. Jay, can you think of a Bible character that praised God, maybe even in a difficult circumstance?
Moses.
Ooh, what happened with Moses?
He got really grumpy because his brother Aaron worshipped a calf instead of God.
You're right! That's a great Bible story! And you know, Moses still obeyed God throughout that whole circumstance, and God honored him for that. I know someone too, King or David did. He became a king, but before he was king, King Saul was hunting David. Seriously hunting David! That's scary. And during that time, it's believed believe that David wrote this song. Psalms 27:1 says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my strength and my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?" He praised God through the hard times, and we should do the same. Jada, after all this talk about worshiping God, I think we should get some puppet friends together and do some worshiping. What do you think?
Me too. David is king over Israel, and they're bringing the Ark of the Lord home. They're returning it to Jerusalem, and it's like a giant homecoming party parade. There's people celebrating and dancing and playing music. They're sacrificing to the Lord. It's a huge party. The Ark is coming home. And God has chosen a king, and Israel's back to worshiping God. David is so happy and thankful to God that he is literally leaping and praising the Lord, worshiping him. Now, how many kings or even people do you know that you've seen leap and dance and praise before the Lord? It doesn't happen very often. And his wife got really upset. Now, she could not believe that he would act like that. She thought it was dishonoring for David to act like that, that a king should not act like that. But here's what David said back to her in the New King James Version. David said to Michal, "It was before the Lord who chose me instead of your
father and all of his house, to appoint me ruler over the people of the Lord, over Israel. Therefore, I will play music before the Lord, and I will be even more undignified than this, and will be humble in my own sight. He told her that he would even act more crazy, more undignified than he had already acted, if it would bring glory to the Lord, even if it embarrassed himself. David was praising and dancing God, and he didn't care what he looked like because it was pleasing to God. I challenge you to be like David in every single worship service and even in your everyday life, because he was willing to be undignified, and he's an example to us. We should be willing to be undignified to worship our Lord also. Get a little sweaty. Ladies, let those bobby pins go flying. Do whatever it takes to worship God. Let there be rug marks on your head. Let you leave church with your face all red and blotchy. If it brings glory to God, that's the only thing that matters, because we want to praise and worship him every day. When you lay your head down tonight and when you wake up in the morning, give the Lord praise and worship, because he is worthy of all of our praise.